November 4th, The Authority of Truth. Draw near to God, and He will draw near to you. James 4, verse 8. It is essential that you give people the opportunity to act on the truth of God. The responsibility must be left with the individual. You cannot act for him. It must be his own deliberate act, but the evangelical message should always lead him to action. Refusing to act leaves a person paralyzed, exactly where he was previously. But once he acts, he is never the same. It is the apparent folly of the truth that stands in the way of hundreds who have been convicted by the Spirit of God. Once I press myself into action, I immediately begin to live. Anything less is merely existing. The moments I truly live are the moments where I act with my entire will. When a truth of God is brought home to your soul, never allow it to pass without acting on it internally in your will, not necessarily externally in your physical life. Record it with ink and with blood. Work it into your life. The weakest saint who transacts business with Jesus Christ is liberated the second he acts, and God's almighty power is available on his behalf. We come up to the truth of God, confess we are wrong, but go back again. Then we approach it again and turn back until we finally learn that we have no business going back. When we are confronted with such a word of truth from our redeeming Lord, we must move directly to transact business with him. Come to me, Matthew 11, verse 28. His word come means to act. Yet the last thing we want to do is come. But everyone who does come knows that at that very moment, the supernatural power of the life of God invades him. The dominating power of the world, the flesh, and the devil is now paralyzed, not by your act, but because your act has joined you to God and tapped you into his redemptive power.